Hi everybody, we're here in the Academy Day number 5 in Venice at the Movotel, and I have with me Christian Claassen from D-Box, who's been presenting yesterday and today. And I would just like to ask him a few questions. And to begin with, I would like to ask you, what is your favorite projects that you did during your years in D-Box? And if you can give an example of what your daily work looked like during such a project.
So I spoke about today about 425 Park Avenue, and that was one of the real moments that I was really kind of happy. And when I see Norman Foster presenting our work, that's one of the kind of things that when you're proud of your work and you can see it in the global kind of market and see it around. And today, my day-to-day in the office now is really directing the team and maintaining the relationships between clients and team members and controlling the workflow and the kind of general setup of the CGI department.
Okay, and if I can add to that one, it's really interesting because D-Box is more like a complete agency providing a full service, starting from branding and all the way to publication of a project in print, in TV. So CGI is just a part of this. So if you can maybe shed some light how the big team synchronizes such a project, and also if you can add comments to projects being done in London and New York specifically, because you've shown in your presentation you have a rough full city model that you use to do the pre-visualization. So I would be interesting to learn about that also.
So the teams are really kind of built up, and there's I'll take the London office as an example. I know better. I mean, we've got the CGI, the photography department, graphic design, and when we start on a project, there's really kind of the pitching process for the project that you go through. I mean, there's documents and presentations that we put together as a team that involves all the partners, the team members. We're all collaborating on that kind of pitch idea of what the concept is behind our approach to the scheme. Each project is different, and the kind of scope, and then the CGI team, like, as I've shown today, is kind of double-faceted, and when we're not working on these big account jobs, it is we're looking at day-to-day from architects and art visualizations.
Okay, and to wrap it up, I'm always interested in doing things the photo real way, or doing them more stylized, and you did mention that you see yourself more as illustrators rather than photorealist artists. So I would like to ask you more about it, and knowing that you love photography, how does that play together, and what's the main thing that you try to get in a shot, in an image? What's the most important thing relating to the photorealism versus being more artistic about it?
I think the most important thing for our images is a narrative, and it's telling a story. The photography side of it, I mean, that's where I have my own sort of fascination in trying to replicate certain parts of photography, but also knowing that I'm in control of those bits, and if I need to change the settings or to tweak things, and I've got that control that I don't have in the real world of photos. And it's about just capturing those kind of moments and putting the time in to find that where those unique vantage points or unique times of day where the architecture or the design is working.
One more, you use photography not just as the general setback for the project, you use it for taking pictures of almost every prop and also specifically taking shots of people within the shots. Is this always the process, or do you sometimes use pre-made shots of previous projects, or just, you know, libraries available online for a specific shot, or is always something that is customly made for a specific project? I mean, do you always aim to be dedicated per each project, with everything, all the assets that you create for.
Every project we try and approach in the same way, and the level of it's that level of detail where if we have the right member or the right person to fit scenes, and we will try to do the custom shoot. We're introducing a lot more now that when the client is very specific about the type of people that they want, then that is the service that we provide, where we want to get those custom people in so they can be fully integrated into the view, and we're not trying to just go and capture people on the street. And it's a lot more kind of directed and thought about in the process.
Okay, thank you very much, Christian, and I hope you enjoy this one, and I invite you all to come to the Academy Day number 6 next year. So thank you very much.